This was done around 1500. Somebody from 500 years ago
originally made this.
And 400 years, people were looking at it, and 300 years, and two.
Yeah. It's been meaningful for audiences for over half a millennium.
Hi, I'm Jessie. I'm a science-y math kind of person, and yet I work at the Getty. Famous for its art and culture. Ooh, Hercules. So I decided to go on a quest to learn about art and discover all I can about becoming artsy.
Many of us learned how to write when we were younger. Fewer of us learned how to write in script or cursive, and even fewer of us learned the art of calligraphy, literally translated to beautiful writing. And when you think of calligraphy, you might think about traditional wedding invitations or seating assignment cards, but beautiful writing has a long history spanning several continents.
On a recent trip to the Huntington Library, Art Museum, and Botanical Gardens, I happened upon an exhibition nestled in the Chinese garden called A Garden of Words, The Calligraphy of Liu Fangyuan, displaying contemporary Chinese calligraphy on the original scrolls that were used as models for the garden stone inscriptions. Chinese calligraphy dates back thousands of years and is still practiced today. In fact, there is beautiful writing all over the world, and I was curious what kind of calligraphy I might find at the Getty. So I decided to meet with Beth Morrison, head of manuscripts, to take a look at some of the calligraphy we had in our own collection.
So, welcome back to the study room and to looking at more manuscripts.
Today we're going to be looking at a selection of manuscripts from around the world, all containing beautiful writing.
When we're talking about calligraphy, how do you discern the difference between like, oh, well, this is calligraphy or this is just writing?
I think that most of what you see in manuscripts, most people would determine is calligraphy because it's taking time and effort to make the writing look beautiful.
Yeah.
First up is one of Getty's most recent acquisitions, a manuscript from 13th century Spain.
This is a copy of the Quran, or these are leaves from a Quran. Because figurative decoration was prohibited in the Quran, a lot of time and effort was spent on the calligraphy because it was the main decorative element for Quran manuscripts in the Middle Ages.
Next up, an Ethiopian manuscript.
It almost looks like numbers or
yes,
a list.
Exactly. You're exactly right. So this is a gospel book. It was done around 1500 in Ethiopia. We think that manuscripts were traded back and forth between the Christian West and East and Northern Africa and into Ethiopia. So there was a lively trade, and the Ethiopian Empire was one of the first Christian empires of the world. So they take a lot of pride in the Ethiopian manuscript tradition there as well.
I think that's really neat because when I think about the Middle Ages and what I was taught in school, it's very Eurocentric.
Yeah, and I don't know that a lot of people know about the history of Christianity in Ethiopia, especially in the Middle Ages. So manuscripts like this really have a chance for us to tell that story and to reveal these things to people who, like you, maybe never learned about Ethiopian manuscripts in school. I certainly
never did. Yeah, I did not.
You ready for the aha?
Yeah, okay, yeah. I was wondering what that was.
And we go.
Oh, wow.
So it's this incredibly beautiful, energetic, colorful image
of
the Virgin and Child. And these are two archangels who are guarding her.
I've never seen anything like that. I mean, I've seen a lot of renditions of the Virgin and Child.
And it really is unique to medieval Ethiopia.
The next manuscript is an Armenian manuscript from 1615.
This one I got out specifically because I think this opening, this is the opening of the Gospel of John, and you can see here he's having the words of God divinely inspired coming right down into his mouth, and then he's dictating them to his assistant here who writes them down. The symbol for John in Christianity is an eagle. So the actual first words of the text is formed out of letters that are made out of eagles.
That is really neat, and not to cheapen this, but it reminds me a little bit of the beach letters you get
with
your
different
names
little
and
kinds
animals
of flourishes.
And things.
Yeah. Yeah. I picked one manuscript that is from the Western tradition. This is a 15th century German manuscript. It's sort of the anti-example. I would still consider this calligraphy because the letter forms are very carefully made, but this is really a book of information. This is a science book, and so the intent of it was not to beautify the Word of God or to have the viewer really concentrate on the words in the same way as an artistic expression, more as an informational expression.
I see a knight.
Yes.
Maybe about to joust.
Yes, exactly. You might be familiar with that. Those are actually allegorical symbols that are meant to indicate the different planets. So each of the planets is pictured as a knight on a horse with different symbols to indicate the different planets. You may have noticed that I have this closed because this is my personal favorite, and I would say many audiences are drawn to this manuscript at the Getty. This scribe, his name was Georg Boschke. Okay. And so this entire manuscript is what we call a manual of calligraphy, in that it shows hundreds of different ways that he could write an entire manuscript, should you want the manuscript in that particular script.
So it's like a flex. It's a bit of a flex.
What that is. Oh. Am I showing
like
my
he's
age?
Like he's like flexing his skills.
Oh, I see. Yes, 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 yes.
Or a catalog of what he could do for you.
Exactly. Exactly. Exactly.
Did he write it? He didn't write it that small. This is a reproduction.
Oh, this is actually large compared to some of the things we're going to be looking at. It is
by hand.
By hand. Yeah.
What?
Yeah, yeah.
Ah!
So it's incredible.
Speaking of by hand, you might notice that Beth is not using gloves to handle this manuscript. That's because using gloves can actually reduce your manual dexterity, increasing the likelihood of damage. So instead, she is using clean, washed hands.
Look at this one.
Oh my gosh, they look like music notes.
Exactly. Yeah. Here you have some peas, which are little round things on individual veins like this, and that is the inspiration based on the calligraphy.
Oh my gosh, this is so extra. Yes. You know that word.
Indeed.
This is like writing and calligraphy, but taken to like a thousand.
Yeah,
it's turned up to 11. Yeah.
And it just goes on and on and on and on.
Oh my gosh, it's the flourishes.
Right, yeah. He's done these sort of little skips in every single one of the letters, and that is then echoed by this leaf that is sort of threaded through the actual parchment.
I think one thing that blows me away about this is just how tiny it is, and that this is not a copy. This is the book that he wrote on. Now every time I go to write, even a half a page, my hand starts hurting.
Oh,
and
Can you imagine doing this entire book or asking someone to write out the entire Gospels?
And just for fun, we decided to sit down and remind ourselves of that feeling of handwriting.
What was the phrase again?
The finger writes, but the whole body suffers.
Okay. Okay. And that's a medieval.
That's a medieval, yeah.
I did like cursive and then print and then it was...
Well, you can imagine how hard it was for them to keep it so consistent. I mean, it's that consistency. You can imagine you're a monk, you're in a medieval scriptorium, it's cold, it's getting dark at 4 o'clock, you've had to write the entire Bible by hand, and you're sitting here, what's a good phrase for this? Ah, the finger writes, but the whole body suffers. And it really was this idea of like writing out books by hand was an act of contrition, but it was also an act of devotion. And they wanted it to be as beautiful as possible because that was their job.
This really gives me a new appreciation for what we're looking at, because it really does take dedication, it takes focus, and it takes artistry. And maybe I'm gonna dive in and learn a little bit more about calligraphy now in my quest to become artsy.